Nyt.
Tervetuloa, tere tulemast, welcome and bienvenue, bienvenida. Dobra pashalovat, dobra došli, tarhip, welcome to the premiere of Tonight Wish with Love documentary film. It's a documentary from fans to Nightwish. Hundreds of Nightwish fans have participated in doing this production. We are not professional TV hosts. We are the directors and scriptwriters. This is Kaisa Alenius. And my name is Harto Hänninen. And of course, the band is coming to see the movie with us. So, Nightwish, are you ready? Please welcome Nightwish to the premiere.
So nice to see you here.
Good to be here.
We are in Himos. Let's get the microphone. We are in Himos at the moment in Finland, and you have concert tonight. So thank you very much for coming here. Floor, would you like to say something to the viewers of Facebook Live?
Like, it's welcome. That camera.
Right. Hello, Facebook viewers. You're not here in Finland, obviously. You're not at Himos. And I bet if you're a fan of Nightwish, you really, really wish you were. So we are very excited that you can still be with us, at least in a modern way, internet way. So I hope you're going to enjoy this. We are very excited and curious. So let's see what's going to happen. Enjoy.
Thank you very much, Flor. Tuomas, what do fans mean to the band?
Just a bunch of lovely people, 99.999% of them. Good fun to be with. I mean, especially during the live shows, you get the interaction with the fans. That's where the energy almost always comes from. It's interaction. You get the energy from them. You play a bit better with better energy. You give it back to them. It bounces back and forth.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And please take your seats and make yourselves comfy here. And so soon we will be watching Tonight Wish with Love documentary film here. You at home will see it at wirely.fi/tonightwish. And if you have some questions for us or for the band about fan documentary or fandom, please post them as comments here at Facebook. We will have time for some questions after the documentary.
We have got information that fans in France, Serbia, Canada, Mexico, Venezuela, Brazil, Argentina are watching us. So people at home, please open another screen and go to our website so we can all watch the movie together. Now everybody will see what we have done.
Now it will start and hope for the best. Thank you. Let's start.
Southern California.
Ich heiße Nina und wohne in Zürich.
Toronto, Ontario, Canada.
Serbia.
Serbia, Uruguay.
France.
Chile.
Uruguay.
São Paulo.
Kaohsiung.
Spain.
Deutschland. Kazakhstan.
Poland. Perth, Australia.
Mexico City.
Haytonville, also known as Music City, Maryland.
Hello everyone, I'm Alona, I'm from Moscow.
Welcome to Augusta, Michigan.
I wish for this night time to last for a lifetime.
Hi, we are Nagri Shekhar.
Hi, I'm Faruza.
I think it's a really lovely idea to do this documentary and I'd like to help in any way I can.
I would absolutely love to be part of the making of the Nightwish documentary. I really need a challenge in my life right now. I want to be part of something really special and something so passionate to my heart.
My name is Jeremy, and I'm from the Philippines. I've been a fan of Nightwish since 2008. My first exposure to the band was through some YouTube videos, and then I saw them in concert in Seattle back in September 2008. Ever since then, I've been following their works until now. And their music has inspired me to do a lot of things, one of which is customizing this 2012 Kia Picanto into what I call Project Nightwish.
J'ai eu cette idée donc parce que la mascotte de Nightwish, si on peut dire ça comme ça, est une chouette blanche. Donc c'est de là que m'est venue l'idée d'avoir deux hiboux personnifiés en Thomas et Marco, mais enfin... J'étais toujours persuadée que je ne finirais pas comme toutes ces filles à moitié à poil à la télévision. Mais en français, on a un proverbe qui dit qu'il n'y a que les imbéciles qui ne changent pas d'avis et j'espère qu'il s'applique aussi à moi. Sinon, ben... Tant pis, je ne serai jamais quelqu'un de bien et c'est tout.
I've been a Nightwish fan now since around about 2003. I've done 55 concerts, sort of length and breadth of Europe. I'm aiming currently to see Nightwish on every continent. So as I said, I went to Colombia just for 4 days, 21,000 mile round trip just to see the band that has brought so much enjoyment to my life over the last few years.
We're here in Acuna Bay in a national park in somewhere in the Sydney area. I've chosen this for the location because, well, as you can see, it screams Nightwish. It has the natural beauty, it has the water, and it's even raining for us, which is ideal. There is a specific world that Tuomas is always talking about, but more than that, he's talking about pretty much all of existence. He's talking about the human realms and this world, as evidenced by the latest album.
Tuomas understands the world in a way that nobody else possibly can. And he puts a little bit of that essence into his writing, into his music, so that those of us who know how can share a bit of that understanding.
The kind of person who becomes an idol is someone who has a powerful essence. Like, they've got something that people connect with intimately. That's what makes you idolize them. You feel like you know them. You feel like they know you, more importantly.
Well, I'll be honest. I applied for this project because I thought maybe it would be a way that I could finally say something to Tuomas. Like, an actual way that in the same way he's been giving his messages to all of us, maybe I could give my message to him.
常常在荧幕上看着你们的 live， 然后梦想有一天可以去你们的演
唱会，然后我最喜欢 MPU 了，他跟我一样是弹吉他的，而且他跟我一样高，我每次 solo 没有喷掉，觉得是因为有 MPU 的保佑。
Dakle, kao što vidite, prvo što uradim, popijem kafu ujutru i pustim Nightwish pesmu.
Pre tačno 6 godina sećam se kada sam osnovao prvi moj profil na Facebooku. Takođe i napravio fan stranicu koja je tada bila jedna među prvima. Po nazivu Nightwish fanpage. Verovali ili ne, danas je dostigla preko 100.000 vernih Nightwish pratioca.
Ja mislim da biti fan nečega, bio to band, određeni muzičar, film ili bilo koja poznata ličnost, bilo šta, da to znači verno voleti nešto, posvetiti se tome kao je Nightwish. U granicama normale, naravno.
Ovo je jedan crtež u tova.
Kada bih Nightwish došao u moj grad Kragujevac, iako mislim da je to malo nestvarno, ali ja verujem u svoje snove, pošto su oni već jednom bili u malo bližem gradu u Novom Sadu 2008. godine, tako da verujem u taj dan. Pokazao bih im dosta znamenitosti u svom gradu. Ovde iza mene se nalazi malo jezero. Takođe u našem gradu imamo i veće jezero, gde je prelepo, mirno za opuštanje i za šetnju, divno. Prelepa priroda. Takođe imamo razne restorane, pogotovo vegetarijanske za flor. U našem gradu se proizvodi naš srpski duvan, pretežno za marka, cigarete. Takođe alkohol, vina, rakije i ostalog. Onda pokazao bih takođe muzej koji je u našem gradu poznat i ogroman park. Ali prvo mesto koje bih pokazao kada bi Nightwish došao u moj grad Kragujevac je moja soba.
There was a band called Nightwish. There was Tuomas, the maestro, who used his great magic to write the songs. Marco on bass, who sang and joked around, while Empu played guitar with a cheeky grin. Yuka on the drums always wore his bandana, and Troy played the pipes, and everything else. And lastly, there was Floor, the band's voice. She joined really suddenly, and she's loved it. Yuka couldn't sleep and could no longer play. So Yuka's friend Kai stepped in, and the quest continued with a new friend. Their music was magical. Nothing would stand in their way. The story is long, and there's so much more to it. Come with us now, and we'll show you.
Bueno, como pueden ver, hoy vamos a hablar de Finlandia. Yo les puedo contar que conocí a Nightwish en el año 98 a través de una revista en donde estaban presentando acá el disco Angel for First y decían que provenían de un lugar llamado Kite en Finlandia.
Moi, mitä kuuluu? Minun nimi on Sergio. Olen argentinalainen. Nightwish Fanny.
Quisiera compartir con ustedes estas fotos muy especiales para mí. Este es mi arribo a Kite en una noche mágica. Este es el Kaupunk Italo de Kite. Esta es la escuela de Kite, una escuela hermosa. Y por último, el lugar más hermoso en el que estuve. Kiten Kirko. Tama un kaunen paika. Yosa olen olut.
When I was 10 years old, I got very, very sick, and I was in and out of the hospital quite a lot. And one night from my hospital bed, I was up late listening to the radio, and the announcer played this beautiful metal cover of a song that I knew well. It was Walking in the Air. And I'd known that song for years, since I'd seen The Snowman since I was like two years old. And then here was this beautiful cover that I'd never heard before. And so I remembered the name of the band, Nightwish, Nightwish, Nightwish. And when I got out of the hospital, I looked up the band and that was it. I was hooked. Here's the thing. I've never traveled outside of the country before. I have never gone outside of the United States. And you know, there's all this deal being made of, oh, you're going to Finland, you're studying abroad, so exciting. But I've never actually been outside of my own country before. And it's kind of embarrassing to admit. It's not for lack of desire to go out. I mean, when I was younger, we would always make these plans about going to France or going somewhere in Europe as a family. But it never happened because I was so sick for so long. I also hope that I get to travel around the country a little bit. Also to Kite, of course. I made it. I'm here in Kite, and I don't know how to describe it. It's beautiful. I suppose it's kind of like walking into a Nightwish song. Feels like home, feels like something familiar.
I have met them. The first time I properly met Nightwish was in Glasgow on the Imaginarium tour because I'd won a meet and greet. So I went backstage after the show and I was very nervous. And I planned out in my head all these things I wanted to say, like, well, just to say thank you for sharing this beautiful music with the world. Because it just makes me so happy and it's given me some really happy memories, stuff like that. But when the time came, I didn't say anything. I just sort of stood there, really nervous. They all came over to say hi, and then, oh, I didn't say anything. So that was a very, very special day. And I also ran into them the day after at Glasgow Airport. I did actually have a flight to catch. I wasn't just, like, stalking them. And I remember my dad was talking to Marco about how hard it is to raise children. So thanks, Dad. But if I meet them again, I will say thank you for sharing this music with the world and for the amazing tours that they've done.
Hi, Nightwish. I'm Juliet and I'm 15.
I'm Laura and I'm 11.
And we're from New Brunswick, Canada. Our Nightwish story has been basically our entire lives. Our parents are huge fans and we've been listening basically since we were babies. My father doesn't know we're trying to be in this documentary. When it's released, we really want him to watch it and we want him to be surprised by seeing us in the documentary. We thought we'd show you around since our dad isn't home and he can't see us. Showing you around, so
come on, Laura.
Okay.
We're gonna show you around where we live. This is kind of our backyard. We live in the country, so it's quiet except for the highway.
It's over there.
Yeah.
How do you feel that your father is a Nightwish fan?
I think it's pretty awesome. It's pretty cool to have a dad that listens to music that's different than everybody else.
How has it influenced you and your family life?
It brings our family really close together to listen to Nightwish because we all love them.
Elegí este lugar para representar la atmósfera de lo que significa para mí las canciones de Nightwish porque siento de que las canciones me detienen en el tiempo. Y este lugar, la Estación Astrofísica de Bosque Alegre, pareciera como que el tiempo también se detuvo. Si tengo que ponerle música a lo que es la sensación de la pequeñez en la inmensidad del universo, le pondría una canción de Nightwish. Las letras de la banda hablan mucho acerca de la ciencia, de los astrónomos, del universo, de las constelaciones, de las estrellas.
My first Nightwish related tattoo.
Okay, I was get
present. Yeah. 生日快乐！表姐，生日快乐！快点，刚才说啊，快点！啊，生日快乐！谁啊？换你，生日快乐！
And action.
Did I think 20 years ago that I would ever play Wembley Arena? No. No. I had my dreams and my visions, but this goes beyond that.
I'm gonna
fancy Nightwish at Wembley.
Así que no lo puedo creer. Gracias, Nightwish. Thank you so much.
Boy.
Muito obrigada, tá? Success. Vai ser um show muito grande, então vai ser uma experiência única, vai ser épico, eu acho que vou chorar muito. É, e a gente vai conhecer a banda. Nossa, eu tô muito nervosa em relação a isso, porque eu não sei nem o que, que eu vou dizer. É, eu acho que eu vou apagar, meu cérebro vai apagar e eu não vou conseguir dizer nada. Mas espero conseguir tirar algumas fotos interessantes e gravar alguma coisa. Dessa vez consegui um autógrafo.
Estou levando o encarte do Endless Forms para ver se eu consigo pedir para a banda assinar, já que a gente vai conhecer eles. Eu estou muito animada.
Eu sou uma Tomette, como os fãs brasileiros costumam a chamar. É, os fãs que defendem o Thomas, que gostam do Thomas.
Eu compartilho do conceito de escapismo presente na ideologia musical do Thomas. As músicas do Nightwish me permitem relativizar os meus problemas, as minhas dores, me transportam para uma realidade diferente.
Once upon a time, there was a young boy named Tuomas who loved to imagine things as they could be, not as they were. He stared up at the night sky in wonder. So many stars, I wonder if one of them holds something for me. As time went on, he never forgot that night, and in the mornings, he would work on lyrics and compositions of the songs he had imagined while staring at the lake. I'm so sorry, he breathed, and Tarja smiled at him. It was only later when Mr. Plum and Dimov brought Tarja to Tuomas to introduce them. Tuomas, this is Tarja, and she has a unique voice. Maybe you could record a demo. Tuomas jumped at the chance to record and quickly asked some of his friends to join in, and Nightwish was started.
Era o ano de 2000, um ano importante para a banda, que começa a definir novas mudanças. Wishmaster é liberado e ele permanece no top charts por semanas na Finlândia. O sucesso foi consagrado e a banda tinha o poder de dominar o mundo. O próximo álbum era atacar a América do Sul, desbravando o mundo com a sua primeira turnê mundial. Ao chegar na América do Sul, a banda se encontra com o promotor Marcelo Cabuli. Cabuli se aproxima de Tarja com um certo cavalheirismo e acaba alinhando o coração da vocalista. Depois de terminar a sua turnê com muito sucesso, o tecladista vê uma crise na sua banda. Tuomas precisa ir para Lapônia, Lapland. Havia muito para ser pensado.
Для Найтвиш приглашение в турне принесла. Далее с Марселом сумасшедший поезд покидали. Вдвоем они на дирижабле летали. Томасу все это надоело. Написал письмо для Тарьи и Марселу. Тарью увольняли, а поклонники видали. Солнце уснуло, сказал Томас.
Hanging out in some bushes today, next to a cemetery in a fence row by the road I live on. And today we're gonna talk about the world of Nightwish, their music. I feel as though the music to me is, I can only describe it in motion. So we'll describe it I was going to do a hand gesture, but how can I do that? It's like riding a bike for the first time and then taking off the ground and flying. That's what it's like. It just really inspires you to play music. The first song I got inspired to play, it was actually during a dark time, was The Islander by Nightwish. And that was when my dad was, he actually had cancer, and he was on his deathbed. And it really related in those times to the lyrics. They were a lot like what I was going through. An old man by a seashore at the end of the day. I am a voice of never, never land. The innocence of every man. I am the empty crib of Peter Pan. The sunny cloud against the blue, blue sky. Every chimney, every moonlit sigh. I am a story that could read you real. Every memory that you hold dear. Nightwish is a good music to connect to what's happening in your life. And it's just all around a good feeling. It really, really good feeling.
Bueno, acá en Buenos Aires acaba de amanecer y yo la verdad que no pude dormir, tengo una especie de insomnio, pero recuperar enseguida el sueño normal. Y bueno, lo que pasa es que quedé con la cabeza todo el tiempo pensando en Wembley, salvo excepciones que uno se encuentre con alguien que le gusta la misma música. Así que de repente tener la posibilidad de expresar todas las ideas que nos preguntan en el documental y compararlas, como después las vamos a ver con gente de otros países, fue una experiencia bárbara.
Nightwish, Nightwish,
ole.
¿Para quién les hizo escuchar Nightwish a ustedes?
Papá.
Yo. Gracias a mí, he transmitido el gusto musical a la familia. Así que bueno, estoy muy contento y bueno, nos vemos en Londres.
Buenísimo.
¡A conocer a Nightwish!
¡Quiero ver a Nightwish! ¡Quiero conocer a Flor Jansen!
¡Y a Thomas Halopay!
¡Yo Flor Jansen, a Florcita!
¡Y a Thomas Halopay!
Y nada, queremos pasar los tres juntos un momento allá. Compartir en familia.
Sí, se puede ver a Nightwish. Pero bueno,
también va mi novio.
También vamos, va su mucho. Novio, así que...
Sí, vamos mucho. Papá no quería que vaya, así que fue increíble.
Pero bueno, sí, queremos compartir ese momento con él para que no vaya solo y porque, bueno, no es como una banda que a él le gusta, entonces, bueno, hace su viaje. Papá ya tiene 50 años y nunca hace esto. No es que viajamos nosotros, por eso no viajamos a ningún lado. Es muy raro que pase algo así.
Es la banda que compartimos juntos desde que ellas eran chiquitas y la que vamos a seguir yendo a ver por muchos años más.
Cada vez que vengan a
hasta que yo tenga, hasta que yo tenga 80 años y me tengan que llevar en silla de ruedas, quizás me van a llevar, ¿no?
Greetings, dear band and fellow Imagineers. My name is Eugene, I'm from Ukraine, 22 years old. Currently sailing through Persian Gulf, working as a seaman.
Вот и завершается еще один рабочий день. Через 4 часа снова просыпаться на вахту. Вы знаете, время иногда так невыносимо тянется, а иногда мимолетно, словно падающая звезда. Эта работа, это место учит тебя радоваться маленьким моментам и не зацикливаться на проблемах. Все проходит. Все лечится временем. Я нахожусь здесь ради своих любимых, ради своей семьи, ради своих убеждений и ради своей мечты. Соскучился по дому.
Благодаря эскапизму и атмосфере, которая дарит музыка, творчество, я выдерживаю все напасти.
سلام، من نیکو هستم، تو ایران زندگی میکنم، توی یه بندری نزدیک دریای خزر تو شمال ایران. الان فکر میکنم تقریبا 8 ساله که من نایت فیش گوش میدم، یعنی از اوایل دبیرستان تا الان. خودم بعضی وقتا اونجایی که نقاشی میکشم یه جورایی فن آرت انجام میدم مرتبط با نایت فیش. این تروی اینم فلورو تاریا اینم فلور اینه که اینطوریه اگرم بخوام نایت فیشو با آهنگ های پاپ ایرانی مقایسه کنم که خب اصلا مسلما قابل مقایسه نیست. اینجا من راستش نمیشناسم گروه موسیقی یا که سبکش بخواد مشابه نایت فیش باشه یا سمفونیک متال باشه. احتمالاً هست ولی خب من نمیشناسم. یه مقدارم خب دلیلش اینه که اینجا هنرمندامون رو حمایت نمیکنن، سخت مجوز میدن. باز حالا کسایی که سبکشون سنتی یا پاپ باشه باز بهتره، اونا میتونن حداقل سی دی شون رو پخش کنن، یه جوری به حال به زور مجوز بگیرن، اما سبکای راک و متال نه.
Um pouco mais. E nessa época eu estava perdida no oceano, no meu oceano, com um barco muito pequeno, um minúsculo bote. E esse barco, ele não era suficiente para aguentar todas as ondas que batiam nele. Eu não tinha um porto e eu não tinha uma âncora. Todas as ondas enormes e a tempestade, tudo era muito negro e parecia que ia me tragar e eu iria afundar. Uma hora eu iria afundar. E eu já estava tentando desistir de tirar toda aquela água que entrava e me entregar. E foi exatamente nessa época que surgiu um farol, que foi o Nightwish, que hoje é a minha âncora, é o meu farol, é a minha luz.
I lost my child, and one of the songs that reminds me of him is a story of myself. And I love to travel, and I believe life is on love. And this particular text, I want to travel where life travels and live in a world of snow. Well, yeah, I guess I'm getting there now. And this tattoo was actually signed during the Nightwish week in 2015. Pretty much just a joke between me and Tuomas. But then I thought, as anybody and everyone is getting a tattoo, then why would I not just make the autograph for real? I'm not really a stargazer, but in this particular moment with all my friends there, I thought that would be a nice memory. So that's the story about my Nightwish tattoo.
Ich höre seit 2009 Nightwish und liebe Nightwish, und diese Freude an Nightwish konnte ich auch an meine Familie weitergeben, weswegen ich sie euch gerne kurz vorstellen möchte.
Hallo, ich bin Moni, ich bin die Mutti von Rina und die Frau von Dieter. Und die zwei sind wirklich so große Nightwish-Fans, dass ich dachte, ich schenke den beiden mal eine Karte. Und zwar habe ich die geschickt nach Leipzig zu eurem Live-Konzert 2012. Ich glaube, das war ein ganz tolles Erlebnis für die zwei.
Und anlässlich meines 60. Geburtstags haben mir meine Kinder eine DVD geschenkt mit persönlichen Erinnerungen und unter anderem einer super Produktion von If I Had an Angel. Und ich bin begeistert. Seht selbst.
So, ich bin jetzt in Berlin angekommen und schauen wir doch mal, wen wir hier haben.
Hey, derbe, meine Olin Steffi. Und ich bin die Schwester von Rina. Das hier ist meine Tochter Theodora. Wir hören immer schon fleißig Endless Forms, Most Beautiful. Sie mag den Sound sehr. Tatsache, ist gerade über ein Jahr alt und wir essen zu Abendbrot. Wie ihr seht, ich bin im Video Yuka. Und nicht nur Yuka, ich mache auch den Empu und den Thomas. Hey, hey!
Dann schauen wir doch gleich mal rüber, wer da noch ist. Hallo!
Hallo! Ich bin Micha, ich bin in dem Video der Marco. Mein Bart ist mittlerweile abgefallen und wegrasiert.
Non, ne rêvez pas, il compte pas me la redonner, il gosse la garder pour lui-même. Bon, je ne suis vraiment pas à l'aise avec tout ce qui est selfie, mais bon, je pense que c'est un peu la seule façon de vous que j'ai pour vous montrer un petit peu mon jardin. Donc, j'habite dans une maison qui, une petite villa, qui se situe dans un petit village de montagne dans les Alpes, en France. Et je vais vous montrer un peu la vue que j'ai de chez moi tous les matins, que quand je me lève, que je vois cette vue et ça n'a pas de prix à chaque fois. Regardez ça. Et aussi un peu de ma vision de voir les choses qui sont un peu décalées et c'est pour ça que c'est peut-être pour ça que je me sens bien avec Nightwish, parce qu'il y a le côté imaginaire et le côté émotion que je me retrouve. Et en fait, j'ai pas toujours eu de chance dans ma vie. Je me suis beaucoup retrouvé seul, donc du coup, des fois, ben, j'étais dans mon monde en train de rêver, à jouer tout seul. Depuis que je suis gosse, c'est comme ça et c'est ma façon d'être. Et voilà, ça c'est moi en tenue de combat. C'est vraiment la tenue que je fais tout, quand je fais tous mes combats, mes mêlées, nos spectacles. Quand je suis en tenue comme ça, j'ai l'impression d'être une autre personne, d'être quelqu'un, d'être plus sérieux, d'avoir peur de rien. Un de mes grands rêves, ce serait de former mon propre groupe de métal. Parce que tous les jours, je rêve d'être sur scène, de faire de la musique, de monter. Monter sur scène, faire de la musique. Voilà, faire un groupe, c'est vraiment quelque chose que je rêve depuis des années. J'ai voulu rendre ce rêve réaliste. Mais le truc, c'est que, bon, ben, malheureusement, ça n'a pas fait parce que je ne suis pas si bon que ça à la guitare et puis manque de motivation. Et oui, ça peut paraître bizarre, un manque de motivation pour son propre rêve. Un truc que je me demanderais pourquoi.
After Tarja had been fired, the band was in need of a new singer and got over 2,000 demos to choose from. Imagine the band sitting on a couch, listening to the demos and saying, next, maybe, No. Finally, with bleeding ears, they found their new vocalist, Annette Olsen from Sweden. With her, they produced 2 albums and a movie. Their music made it ring gold and platinum in various countries. The replacement of the singer split the fans in 3 groups. Annette was always compared to Tarja, but many fans really loved the new style she brought into the band and her hip-hop yelling. Annette changed a lot. She changed the music of Nightwish. She changed her look, but she also changed from healthy to sick.
Hi guys, I'm sorry, but I'm sick. You have to cancel the show.
We can't.
Die Leadsängerin der Band fällt nach wie vor aus und die Jungs von Nightwish haben einige Shows mit Ersatzsängerinnen gegeben. Aber ihnen ist natürlich bewusst, dass das kein dauerhafter Zustand sein kann. Und außerdem, dass die Show weitergehen muss. Thomas hat bereits einen Plan B, der jetzt sofort eingeleitet wird. Er kontaktiert Flo Jansen, die fliegende Holländerin. Viele der Fans sind verständlich wütend oder erstaunt über diesen plötzlichen Besetzungswechsel. Und einige sind traurig über den Verlust ihrer geliebten Annette. Aber Flo legt einen grandiosen Start ihrer Nightwish-Karriere hin. Nun stehen sie hier, knapp 20 Jahre nach Beginn dieser märchenhaften Achterbahnfahrt, die Welt erobert und Legionen von Fans aus aller Welt hinter ihnen. Sie sind bereit, die Bühne zu stürmen, mit neuer Kraft und stärker als je zuvor.
Nun, oho, niin, vähän. Odotuksia tältä tulevalta Lontoon matkalta ja Wimbledon keikalta. No siis, mun unelmahan tässä toteutuu monellakin tapaa. Mä pääsen näkemään Nightwishin keikkaan, pääsen käymään Lontoossa. Ja sit se isoin juttu, eli mä saan tavata sen bändin. Tuomas on semmoinen rauhallinen ja ehkä vähän ujohko silleen pikkusen, mutta ei se näy julkisuudessa. Ja mä luulen, että sit kun sen kanssa niin kun siihen tutustuisi ja sen kanssa tulisi hyvin juttu, niin olisi tosi kivaa. Ja siis mä rakastan sitä, että kaikki fanit tai toisten fanien kanssa voi jakaa sitä intohimoa siihen asiaan, mitä fanitetaan. Ja mä oikeasti tykkään siitä ja sehän on niin kuin fandomin ydin, hän on siinä, että on paljon faneja. Ja ne on niinku yksi perhe. Niinku me.
Ser un fan de Nightwish en Cuba es realmente ser un fan de corazón, pues nosotros los cubanos vivimos distanciados de este mercado, de esta industria de la música. Y nosotros nos enamoramos o sentimos por simplemente lo que podemos escuchar. Los cubanos normalmente, de hecho casi todos, estamos obligados a escuchar la música pirateada. Esto es una beca estudiantil. ¡Eti! ¡Saluda a Finlandia! Esta es mi beca y aquí es donde vivo. Son pequeños cuartos. Mi compañera de cuarto por ahí, viendo una película muy rara. Mi gama con toda mi ropa. Una de mis amigas, Camila.
Y conocerlos, cómo reaccionaría
no sé, solo te digo que cuando veo un concierto en vivo, ¿sabes? Cuando veo el video, tú tengo el wagon y cada vez que yo veo la emoción de tanta gente junto, de tanta gente gritando, de tanta gente cantando las canciones que uno ama, yo me erizo, me encantaría estar ahí.
Soñar creo que es la actividad, ¿no?, que más grande nos hace, y el ser soñador es algo que me he considerado siempre como persona. Sueños tengo muchos y grandes, unos más pequeños, otros más humildes, otros más inocentes.
Nightwish connecting people. Eso es una de las cosas más importantes de esto de ser un fan. Y que gracias a este documental, a este trabajo que estamos haciendo, sencillamente nos convertimos en amigos. Y bueno, eso de verdad para mí tiene mucho valor. Eso, ser un fan y poder compartir, tener un vínculo en común y más exponenciarlo como nosotros hicimos y nos volvimos todos amigos.
Nervosa, eu tô um pouco obcecada em relação à minha rota do aeroporto Heathrow até Wembley. Eu já chequei a nossa caminhada até lá 300 milhões de vezes. Já mandei pro Alejandro, já mandei pra Iena, já mandei pra mãe da Iena, a Oti.
Nós conseguimos encontrá-las, finalmente!
I'm at Wembley! I've been queuing since 6 a.m. And now it's 4 o'clock. This is the queue so far.
So excited.
So excited, that means.
We are with Yena, Oti and Iena and Alejandro siempre.
Very far away.
Very far away.
And Camila.
And Camila.
We are here. Yes. 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 Yes.
Yes.
Bachelor of Arts 2016. West Side.
Hello!
Hey! Say hi, guys!
Hi!
Hi!
Hi.
We're going to meet Nightwish!
It really is special for us.
This is so nice. I'm from Brazil. Can you just
really?
Yeah.
That's
I met you on the airport after Rock in Rio show. Yeah, that's nice.
Next year.
Sometimes you were asking about fans. How do you feel about them? I really wish that people and fans, they really would just concentrate on the music and the art and the lyrics and all that, and kind of abandon the cult worship of the members of the band. Just, that doesn't really make any sense. I mean, we really are ordinary human beings, and when people go a bit doolally when they see us, it's not a really nice feeling, at least for me personally.
Really?
No, I really feel like I kind of want to be there.
Like?
Yeah, it's just, I don't get any,
so
any satisfaction from that.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah. No, it's okay, not the way you
I
are, but sometimes
because...
people really, they go a bit overboard.
I'm saying that because I am Brazilian girl, and I know how Brazilian fans act, and that's the way. They act sometimes.
And it's okay, I feel very passionate about certain of my heroes, towards some of my heroes as well. I almost fainted today when Dawkins walked in. So I understand what's going on there, but still, you know, this person worship cult, it's never really a good thing. You can be really passionate about art itself, the music, movies, books,
mm-hmm.
But maybe not so much the people behind them. It doesn't really make any sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
so,
I know. And when people sing your songs, what do you feel in this moment?
Just love connection, I guess. That's
yeah.
The word. You know, people I've never met, I don't know their story. And I feel so strongly about something personal that I wrote 15 years ago. There's true beauty and freedom in that idea.
I've never been to an Irish concert where I've not cried. I always cry.
Well, we get those feelings on stage as well.
This song just makes you feel great. I mean, if you didn't already feel much better than earlier today, or maybe even fantastic by now, this song will kick you right into it. How about that?
Yeah.
Wow. This is a live stream from Himos, Finland, and we have been watching a brand new fan documentary film, To Nightwish With Love, with, together with Nightwish. And you can ask questions about the documentary from the band now at Facebook comments. And
we are the directors of the documentary, Harpa and Kaisa.
Yes, we are.
Thank you.
Thank you.
But I'm sure that now everybody, like including Mariem from Mexico, would like to hear from the band. How was it? Did you enjoy it? Oh, sorry.
Okay. I did enjoy it quite a lot. I've been consciously staying away from watching it. I had a pre-clips or something just in order to see the whole thing in its entirety. And what this tells me is that I've always known that the music of the band seems to affect a lot of people. It touches them in different ways and all that. But in this kind of deepens the understanding of how much it means to a lot of people. It's not just music that you listen to. It seems to bring out playfulness, adventurous things like going to Wembley and all this kind of stuff. And I don't know, I'm moved. I think it's quite extraordinary. And to me, the relationship with the band and fans in certain way is very clear. We give music and these people actually seem to like what we do. And for that, I have to give them respect. It defines the fact that we've actually managed to do something right. They are the people that actually make us able to survive, to continue this thing, write the music, do the albums, do the tours. Because these people, they like the band, they like us, they like the music, they buy the albums, come to the shows and everything. So, yeah. I'm both grateful and respectful for that. Thank you.
Was there any surprises?
That was simply brilliant. It really, really was. It was also surprisingly moving and in a way inspiring to see all this. And I think it was Jenna who said it at one point, which was the highlight of the documentary for me. It's all about sharing. The fact that we're able to bring people together, regardless of nationality, age, gender, race, and give them the chance to live it all together, that's what it's all about. And that was by far the most moving aspect of the documentary for me.
I knew I was going to have to say something, but I'm still in the taking everything in, because it was so much, it was so beautiful and so so beautifully told, the story, because indeed we know, we read things, we hear, we meet a lot of people, but to see it in a documentary like this puts it in a whole new perspective again, a realization, because I'm also just a person who sees the world in a certain way from my end of. And a lot of people see the same world from a completely different angle. A lot of different angles, but we share one big passion, and that's the music of Nightwish. And that is, like Duoma said, it goes beyond boundaries, it goes beyond gender, it goes beyond anything else. And in a time where the world is divided, as it always seems to be, and sometimes a little bit more than normal than maybe now, this is what makes everybody the same. We love this one big family, and what Jenna said was beautiful. And there were a lot of beautiful quotes. I was really touched by the little animations of the story with the books, with the music. I'm probably gonna think, like I know fans think, there was 100 million things I wanted to say and I didn't know what to say really. But I'm truly touched.
Thank you. How about?
I'm quite speechless as well. I think it would have been better with more car chases and more dinosaurs, maybe, chasing people around. But apart from that, I thought the sincerity was hitting me in buckets. It was so lovely to see such honest I think devotion isn't so much the word. I think just honest love of what's going on here, what we actually stand for as well as a band. Yeah, more car chases next time, I think. And I only caught the end because I felt asleep at the beginning. I was asleep for most of it, but it looked really good at the end, what I saw. Yeah, but yeah, wonderful stuff, wonderful.
Yeah, what else to say than the rest of the bandmates? Just have to say that maybe two words came to my mind, like beautiful and really powerful. So thank you, people, thank you.
I think they said everything already, but but we have very nice big family. Thank you.
I want to say to Troy that if you go on as a band more 20 years, there will be dinosaurs. but here we have also the
fossil, you're the dinosaur.
Yeah. Here we have also some of the fans who have been making this documentary with us. For example, here we have Andrea Argentina. So yes. How does it feel now when it's all over?
Well, I feel a mix of feelings now, but really, really happy. Was a long trip, but I'm here with my friends and really, really happy.
Anything you want to say to your friends at home?
Thank you for the support. Thank you for understanding me all the time. And thank you for all.
And also, Hannah, please don't faint. How does it feel? Was it anything what you expected?
It was really special to see it all come together. Like, all we've seen is the little 5-minute videos that we've sent in, so I didn't know what to expect, but it was really like touching and genuine, and it's just a lovely way to connect the fans through a shared love of Nightwish. So thank you.
Thank you. And there are lots of more stuff on our website. There are 18 small mini documentaries, webisodes, and now I think there are some questions from the fans. Kaisa.
Yes, first, Uros from Serbia is asking. This is for
Minupa.
This is for Floor. Uros is an admin of the biggest fan page on Facebook and Instagram called Nightwish Fan Page. The page follows you, Floor, and the band every day. Do you know the Nightwish fan page? And what do you think about that?
I know the page. I know he's on Instagram too. He's a very, very active young man, very passionate. So thank you very much for all you're doing. Spread the word and the love of Nightwish so much.
Thank you. Then we have a question from Laura. I don't know, what's this? Yes, for the band, decide yourself. You help so many people with your music, support them during rough times. Do you have any advice for those who are struggling at the moment?
And this is for all of us, or for
just choose yourself, please.
Well, woman of the band speaking. Well, we problems are. Problems are hard to categorize. Everybody has them, and some are huge and some are small, and sometimes small problems become very big, and sometimes big problems kick you right into survival mode and you get out of it. The only thing that I can think of, regardless of where you are and what you do, it's great to sometimes take some distance from things, to look at it from a higher perspective, to overlook the whole situation, to think of the worst that could happen. Sometimes things aren't that bad, just to get you out of the negative cycle that maybe creates a downward spiral. Everybody's entitled to their own misery, however. So it's when it's bad, it is. It's okay. But it's great when you're able to deal with it and get out of it. So good luck with that.
And then here is one question, and I have answer for that. Jose is asking, will the documentary be available? Yes, it's available on our website for free and worldwide. Harto.
Yes, and I have one question here. Diego from Venezuela, you saw him in the documentary. He writes that he had a dream where he met you, Thomas. And in the dream, he asked from Thomas about the song Everdream. So now it's a question about music. It has an interesting key change in the last chorus. Instead of going one or two tones up, it goes one and a half tone. It feels perfect, but why did you choose to do it, Thomas?
Oh, you're asking things like that I did 15 years ago. I can't remember what I did yesterday.
But you said that people should ask about music.
Yeah. Well, everybody loves a one and a half tune modulation up. We use it all the time. Come on. I think it's in like every other song we've ever done. You find that particular modulation, so it just seems to work.
So it's your favorite. As a composer.
I guess so, yeah.
It's your trademark. Then Christiana from Ocean Soul of America is asking, what aspects of this documentary surprised you most?
Lack of dinosaurs.
Like Flora said, it's so much to take in. I mean, this was the second time I saw it. I was the only one of the band who had seen the documentary before. But still, it's such a big bite to chew that I need to digest it a little bit. But like Troy said, the sincerity, well, it didn't actually come as a surprise. We all knew how sincere the fans are. But give me some time to think about that.
Okay, we'll get back to it.
If I say something about that, I guess the most surprising thing is that when you get people who got so much enthusiasm, so much words to share, and you put them all together, and the whole thing gets a life of its own because of that energy. I've seen billions of documentaries where you got a bunch of talking heads, but this has like the sincerity and the energy is what carries it, and why it carries it is because it's absolutely genuine. It's great.
And I have to say that I'm surprised that so many fans helped us. It was really great.
And as a comment to Marco, I must say that I don't think that we could have made this kind of documentary with a film crew. It's all about sincerity comes when people film themselves, and they decide themselves what they want to show, what they want to share about their life, and that's a brilliant thing.
It is real.
Yeah.
Then Anissa is asking, I have a question. We have just seen how your music made many lives better. I wonder, what do you think about this aspect of being a musician? I mean, do you think that a musician must be a person who only makes good music, or is it right that a musician has this great role in people's lives, providing help that goes beyond mere entertainment?
I think it's a bit in the eye of the beholder, how you take it. When I sing a lyric that Thomas wrote, what it was last year or 15 years ago, his emotions and my emotions are not the same, because it can't be. I will tell the story my way because I am me. And the person listening to it will take it in differently all the time, because everybody is different and comes with their own little baggage in life. And as some people will just listen to it and think, oh, that was lovely, nice song. And other people will connect deeply and find it therapeutical, and and so on and so forth. And I think that's really what it is. I don't really see my purpose in life to be there as a therapist, a social worker, the musical social worker. More that what I tell is for you to decipher in your way. And yeah, we're not the band that stands for any political stuff or will say, you have to think like this because we do. So that makes things easier, maybe in a sense, to really decipher it your own way. But still, we make music because we tell our story.
Yeah, there's absolutely nothing wrong in music being just pure entertainment. I like my fair share of Bon Jovi and ABBA every now and then. But music, at its core, is all about self-discovery to me. Yeah. And that's from Troy. Self-discovery, that's all it really is. So when I want to go into that mood, I put on a Vangelis CD, and that's where music really is for me. And I do music for very selfish reasons. And that is the only way to keep the music pure.
Then, question to Empu. Elisabeth is asking, what is your favorite Nightwish song?
Take the other one.
Wait a second.
Okay, you have a concert today.
Too many choices.
What was it?
What was it?
Too many choices.
Oh, too many choices. Yeah. You're right.
Okay. Then Bailey from Canada is asking, are you guys excited for your vacations now?
When it starts.
Yeah. We've traveled a lot these last, it'll be around 18 months by the time we finish this tour. So it's been a long tour, but we have this curious reaction when we stop, when the vehicle stops and goes into its garage. We have this peculiar thing where 5 days of relaxation and peace and outward breath of, yeah, it's finished. But then the following week we want to get back out again and we want to start all over again. that's how I feel. I know that's how most of us feel. It's a strange way of life that we live. And we're very cocooned in what we do as well, the way we travel, the way we all live together. And it's not easy to wrench yourself away from this way of life and go back to civilian life. It's not easy, but we've done it enough. We can do it.
Are you coming to visit me?
No, never. I'm not interested.
So time is flying. We only have time for one more question, and that comes from Rafael Cuba. You saw him in the documentary. He wants to know if the band has ever thought of performing in Cuba. And could they perform Phantom of the Opera live? Because Raphael thinks that it would suit beautifully for Flo's voice.
Thank you, Raphael. I think we would all love to go to Cuba.
Yeah, we've had some talks now and then of actually bringing the song back, but it has just never really happened. It's just been talks. But I guess that if we go to Cuba, all of us heard that, and so let's keep it in mind. We'll see if it can be arranged. First you gotta talk to the promoters, Raphael, and get them to book us. We don't know anybody from there, except you.
And has anybody of you visited Cuba as tourist? No. Well, you have plenty of joy ahead when you go, I think.
Yeah. There's some good cigar smokers in this band, including me. So it would be lovely. So,
Nightwish. Thank you for your time, thank you for your performances and music that has inspired so many people.
And thank you all viewers and all fans here and there who have helped us to make this real.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye.
height of fellow Imagineers, this will be the ultimate documentary of your lives.
Nightwish fans can be easily identified by the Nightwish merchandise.
In Norga.
Singapore.
Moscow.
Buenos Aires.
Thailand.
Deutschland.
When I was 10 years old, I got very, very sick.
Because at that point in time, they told me I only had 6 months, maybe 6 months left to live.
I'm gonna move to Finland and marry an awesome man. So let's hope, fingers crossed, I will keep stable enough to actually build up a life.
And sitting in Finland, I finally been able to travel out of my own country.
Their songs are amazing because when I listen to them, I travel to a world of fantasy. I disconnect from this world.
Mi sueño más grande es estar en un concierto en vivo de Nightwish, verlos una vez por todas ahí en el escenario, cantando las canciones que tanto me gustan, gritando, saltando, sudando.
And all of this is because my love for the music of Nightwish.
This is going to be super interesting for us to see as well.
All my dreams are already coming true. Everything's coming true. And it's beautiful.